Hey there. Welcome to Life, Noggin. Hey, a snow cone. Thank you so much. Welcome to another episode of Dear Blocko. Grab your eggnoggin, because this one is holiday themed. Natalia asks, Dear Blocko, can you explain flu season and why it happens? Ah, the human flu season. The time when those evil flu viruses are at their worst. In the United States, flu viruses are actually a thing year-round. But the flu season, which usually occurs in fall and winter, is when those viruses are the most common. Influenza activity usually starts to increase around October, peaking between December and February, then lasting as late as May. Exactly just why the flu becomes more of a problem around these times isn't really known, but we do have some theories. Some argue that it's related to how you live your life in colder weather, being in more crowded situations, or not getting enough sunlight, while others think it has more to do with the viruses themselves. A 2007 study on the topic said that the viruses thrive more in the cold and dry conditions of the flu season. No matter why the flu season happens, the CDC estimates that since 2010, the flu has caused somewhere between 140,000 and 960,000 US hospitalizations each year. So, it's a pretty significant problem. On to the next one, Shadow Ninja Star 999 asks, Dear Blocko, why does our teeth chatter when we're cold? Your teeth chatter when you're cold because the muscles in your face are moving all about to try to get warm, kinda like I do when Triangle Bob leaves the window open. In general, shivering or getting the chills is your body's way of producing heat when it is or feels cold. Shivering is often caused by a cold environment, but it can also be a sign of a bacterial or viral infection. Once you're shivering, all this motion with your facial muscles causes your teeth to keep banging into each other, or chatter, turning you into a human music box. Hey, this is actually pretty good. I think we need more sleigh bell, though. Yeah, that's good. And now it's time for questions about me, or my world. Yours Plays asks, Dear Blocko, what do you want for this upcoming Christmas? Love you, Blocko. Hey, thanks. Love you too. You don't really need to get me anything, don't worry. I don't really need anything since my animator can just make something pop up out of nowhere. All I have to do is wish for it. Here we go. And then there's this. And maybe, you know... Oh, how did you get here? That's crazy world, right? I was just thinking about mashed potatoes or something. Animator, what are you doing? We're gonna get demonetized. Swipe to the next thing. Do the rainbow swipe thing. Do the rainbow. Toby Senpai asks, Dear Blocko, do people in your world celebrate different holidays? Yeah, we actually celebrate all of the holidays. Christmas, Kwanzaa, Hanukkah, Gurple Day, of course, 20-piece Nugget Day, that's a great one. And of course, we celebrate everyone's favorite holiday. Staying up until 3 a.m. thinking about that one thing that you did that was really awkward and maybe nobody noticed, but you think everyone did, so you're really self-conscious about it? Anyway, happy holidays, everybody, from the Life Noggin team. Do you have a question about your world or my world? Let me know in the comment section below, and of course, use the hashtag DearBlocko so I can find it. And if you're not getting any presents this year, you can have this. I don't know what it is, but it's yours, if you want it. Enjoyed this episode of Dear Blocko? Check out the previous one we did. Dear Blocko, what happens when a snake bites you? A snake bite? Ouch. I hope you're not asking from personal experience. That's because a snake bite can be pretty dangerous, especially if you're talking about one from a venomous snake. As always, my name is Blocko. This has been Life Noggin. Don't forget to keep on thinking.